Aye, 'tis true. I'll take him to Ogoth's beard and set him up with a woman named Thorella. Don't you worry yourself, none. All right.
Every hamster has his day. Make way, villainy. Hero coming through.
We'll talk to her again because we're going to head back this way. We're just going to explore right now. This is exploring time. And, yeah, picking up quests and finishing them if that's along our way. Otherwise, we come back and do it after we're done exploring.
Hey, sexy. Do you want to take a look at me, Diddy?
You don't have to talk to us like that. We're helping you. We're not customers. He will take you and your brother. It only costs 200 gold pieces. Thank you, Minsk. I am in your debt. Please get rid of Kremi so that we will be free to leave. I told Ginny that I paid Callahan to take her and her brother off the isle. She was happy, but I still have to deal with Kremi to free them. Okay. Small areas. What's this? Something stuck in a window? Well, come here.
Fleet of foot and all that.
Hopefully you get hit by lightning like what happens in the first game. Another wand of paralyzation. Oh, must have been the save. It was like there was a delay with it going to my inventory. Yeah, another wand of paralyzation. This one with 5 charges. That one has 6. It's really handy for, like, when party members go under chaos and stuff. Just paralyze them. Or for guards, and you don't want to hit them and get a reputation hit. Oh, wait. Did I use up? Good. Now I can actually slot these in. Okay. I'll give her that one back. Oh, here, and take this. I tend to save the better bullets for later, just in case, because we're only in chapter 4 right now. Even though chapter 2 lasted like 100 episodes and chapter 3 lasted like, what, 12 or something?
Don't teach my hamster to suck eggs!
Alright. Now we're up here. What's this place?
Yoshimo is willing.
No idea what this is.
Butt kicking for goodness!
Perth the Adept.
Where Minsk
in the name
goes,
of the council, I am here to keep order.
Aside.
Is it time once again for the experiments? I await your instruction, Warden. You talking to us or to someone else further in the room? I guess I'm speaking as Minsk. I am here with Sapphire. You! Are you of the Cowled Wizards? I demand something from you. Demand? No one demands except the Warden. Demands? Well, you were calling us the Warden. You are in the company with Sapphire. The likeness of who to recognize have been given to me in my head. Sapphire? Sapphire? This guy losing his mind. This isn't right, says Aerie. I don't think he's in control of himself. Maybe dominated or something? Sapphire, if the subject is encountered, do not hesitate to test her limits. These are valuable parameters for study. No one will be testing anyone's limits while Yoshimo is involved. Do you hear, fool? Yoshimo! Yoshimo. Inconsequential. Acceptable losses in exchange for the benefits of learning the limits of Sapphire. Okay. So he would know who Yoshimo is because he was in the dungeon with us. He's the first joinable party member we came across. Well, other than ourselves. It was Jahira, Minsk, and myself, right? And then we came across Yoshimo. And then we got out. Think harder, you fool. That can't be right. You do not matter. You will be dealt with as is convenient. Okay, now that sounds like Irenicus. Where's Imuin? Take me to Irenicus. Okay, now settle down. Are you in control of yourself? Perhaps I can help you. Test of limits. Yes. Test of limits. Okay. I have two ways to get inside the asylum. I can obtain a ward stone from a retired cowled wizard named Perth, who lives somewhere in town. Okay, he lives right here. I guess we're about to obtain a ward stone from him. Or I can visit the pirate lord Desharik. Oh, Desharik and the pirate lord are the same person. Okay, good to know. And convince him that I am a deviant. Desharik's house is in the northwest side of town. Perth's home is... Come to think of it, I didn't ask. Well, Perth's home is right here that we're inside, so I don't know why that shows up like that. Mirror image. He wants to test my limits. I'm not in the mood to have my limits tested today, sorry. Did we use blur? Oh, we didn't rest since the last time. Okay. I don't suppose we can rest in this house after we kill him. It appears that Perth the Adept was under some kind of magical domination and he attacked without provocation. Hopefully this ward stone that was on his person will allow entry to the asylum. Yeah, this shouldn't show up. This shouldn't pop into the journal until we've killed him. I don't know why it does now. No problems. A spell book and wardstone for asylum. This is the wardstone obtained from Perth the Adept. It should lower the wards to keep you from entering Spellhold. 18 pounds. Here, Minsk. It's for you. Actually, Dorne can carry just as much. And hardly carrying anything. As far as slots, anyway. And then this... There's obviously a spellbook of some kind, but the tome will not open until you know the true name of the book. You shall have to identify it. Aerie, if you would do the honors with a spell. What? This is an artifact, isn't it? Book of Infinite Spells? It sounds familiar, like something I saw in like the Advanced Dungeons and Dragons... Dungeon Master Guide. This ancient tome creaks as you open it. Each page of the spell... I can't talk. I'm excited. Okay, calming down. This ancient tome creaks as you open it. Each page of the Book of Infinite Spells contains a spell described in layman's terms easy enough for a thief, a cleric, or even a fighter to understand and cast it. Each spell on a page can be cast once per day. A second function of the book is to turn to a different page of the book. This allows for the possibility of getting a better spell. However, once the page is turned, the previous spell is lost forever unless it happens to appear again. Be warned, once you turn to the last page of the book, you are stuck with that spell. The spell on this page is Fireball Evocation. And it's describing what Fireball is. Huh. I must do the honors on this one. I'm sorry. Abilities. Fireball or turn a page. So if I go done, am I casting the spell at that point? Even a fighter can understand and cast it. So I could give this to Minsk or Dorn and have them throw a fireball. I'm really curious about this. Yeah, we'll see. I'll have Dorn throw a fireball soon. And I don't know if it resets then. Well, it does give some information here. It can be cast once per day. So in other words, the previous spell will be lost forever unless it happens to appear again. Okay, so it looks like this is basically a fireball book. Until we turn the page, and then it's a, you know, who knows what, magic missile book. I thought maybe you'd cast a fireball and it would switch to a different spell. I mean, maybe, but it doesn't indicate that. That's crazy, though. Okay, and then we got the ward stone, and there's some stuff over around here, so...
What do you need? I am skilled in avoid... You're right behind me, right?
This is trapped. History of the Drow 2. We've read that. That's from the first Baldur's Gate. It's a two-book series. Oh. That could have been dangerous. A rainbow obsidian necklace and one gold. Why? Why is that even trapped and locked? Oh wait, there's a little something here. Oh! That's the best. There we go. He's got six. Here. Make Dorn have six as well. Six, six. We have the smaller ones. Yoshimo has four. That's a good amount. That's a lot of extra healing. It might be the most we've ever had.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle. Live by the sword. Oh. Live a good long time.
That was really exciting. See what else is around here. Oops, didn't mean to hit that. Sometimes I miss hitting tab. And I press Q. And it quick saves. What do you do with a drunken sailor? Ooh. Pirates attacking.
What?
Come get some.
Is that what he has? A heavy crossbow? He has a light crossbow. Plus one. Well, why were you...
Cities always teem with evil and decay. Let's give it a good shake and see what falls out.
So why was he attacking this drunken guy? He wasn't even defending himself.
Are we gonna kill something now? Come on, maybe? Something small. Anything. Huh?
We did just kill this small pirate.
Very well.
Hiya.
As the boy who burns the boat and the sea, the boy who loots her. Looting. Alright, well, you might be telling us the truth, but you're too drunk to understand. So. Greyhand?
Let us speak and be done with this.
With all its people and their accumulated wealth, yes?
There you are. Yes, you are the one, aren't you? You are the one he wants. Have we met before? Ah, yes. The tone is as described. You are Sapphire, aren't you? Sapphire of Baldur's Gate, whose father is Garion. No. My name is Yoshimo. Yes, now you look with more interest at me. Well, it will not last. I have but one reason for being here. You will not survive my deadly intent. All right, I'm listening. Who sent you? What do you want? Oh, I am no one to you. You have no reasons to know me, no reason to believe what I say, but I don't care. No one sent me, but I am here because of someone and their interest in you, Arrhenicus, or Bodhi, or both. I owe that someone a debt, and I will pay it through you. So you seek to capture me for someone else? Perhaps I can make a counteroffer. Capture? No, that's not what I intend, and neither will this aid someone else. In fact, this will severely hamper his goals. Oh, they're talking about Arrhenicus, because Arrhenicus still wants to experiment on me. But he can't experiment on me if I'm dead, right? You, Sapphire, are of great interest. By killing you, I will severely hurt the one I hate. It is my revenge for his treatment. Oh, maybe we can talk to this person, because we're in the same boat. Really? He was another captive of Arrhenicus? He came to my home where I was healing, where my mind could rest. He disrupted the place, subjected us to his will, and now he waits for his plans to be complete. He is Arrhenicus, you are his quarry, and I am the avenger that will destroy his plans by destroying you. I don't understand. I seek Arrhenicus for my own revenge. Why target me? Do not confuse me. You're in league with him. You must be. He tortures in preparation for you. You are his excuse. His plans center on you, and for that, you will die. I tell you that I am as much his enemy as you are. No, you are twisting what I know. I am not so ill that I cannot understand this. He plans for you, and you are valuable to him. This makes you my enemy. I don't understand. He must pay for what he has done, what he continues to do. You are the means for that payment. Let's see if we can talk him out of this. You make no sense. I would be your ally. Are you mad? You are not the same evil that he is, but if you are not in league, what does he need? This does not make sense. This does not make sense. No. These must be lies. They must be. I may be mad, but I will not believe lies. You're in league. You're in league. And by your death shall the mad be avenged. I have walked the path from Spellhold dreaming of this moment. The plans of the torturer will fail as you die. Right. I'll wipe your filthy lineage right out of the realms, he says. Wait. Quintuple damage. And stunned.
Armored, sharpened, and raring to go.
I'm gonna sail over those.
I'll hurt you if I have to.
Takes care of that.
Yes?
So that's the way out, huh?
Stand back for justice!
Alright. We got leather armor plus two. Ooh. Boots of hastened departure and a jade ring. These boots were crafted in ages past by the half-elven abjurer known as Fenuel the Seer by her few friends, and Fenuel the Charlatan by her many disgruntled customers. A regular feature in Athkatla, Trade Meet, and the other mercantile hubs of Om, she was a common sight peddling her wares, a series of potions designed to do anything from curing warts on various parts of the body to causing the imbiber to fall in love. Unfortunately, while she was pretty decent at marketing, her skills in the potion enchanting department left a lot to be desired, and as time wore on, she found herself having to skip town more and more, often to stay away from angry mobs. Deciding some safeguard to be prudent, she crafted these boots, which came in very useful at avoiding the rotten fruits and less savory missiles which came her way all too frequently. Fenuel and Boots were parted one evening in Nashkel when, after retiring for the evening, customers managed to catch up with her and she was forced to flee through the window in only a nightgown. Unsurprisingly, she didn't dare return for the boots and hasn't been seen around much since. Neither the boots, for that matter, until now. The wearer can activate the power of the boots at will. When used, the ability lasts for 20 seconds. It gives the wearer a bonus of plus 6 to all saves and plus 8 to armor class. However, the wearer may not attack, cast spells, use thief skills, or stealth while the ability is in effect. Wow. Can't attack, use spells, or use thief skills, which includes stealth. It's kind of like a sanctuary. Yeah, I don't know. Let Dorne hold on to it. Yeah. Actually, that's it. Who is using it? Minsk? Electrical resistance. Okay.
All the world is blood. You're gonna.
I'll take a quick look over here. Oh, Simmy's over here. Just talk to her.
All the world is blind to my passing.
How goes your search, Sapphire? Have you found means to enter the building yet? I have a ward token that will unlock the gates. Then get going. I'll try and get a message to Aaron about what has happened. Perhaps he can get some help now that the way is clear. She leaves, okay. Now that I have the wardstone to enter the asylum, Simmy has left to send a message to Aaron Linvale. She hopes that we can get some help from the Shadow Thieves now that the way into the asylum is clear. Alright, well, we're not going yet. Obviously. We barely explored this place.
All the world is blind to my passing.
All right, back down here.
You require my counsel, yes?
Battle bow. Run, bow, run!
All the world is blind to my passing.
Pirate Dora Guard. Go this way first.
All the world is blind to my passing.
There's this crummy guy.
All the world is blind to my passing.
Hi. I'm a busy man, friend. Why don't you go and bother someone else? There's no need for that. I've found the man I'm looking for. Why would you be looking for me? I don't even know you. But you do know Jinya and Aizen, do you not? What is the meaning of this? Those leeches are my property. Stay away from them. I will not allow you to abuse those two any longer. You're messing with the wrong man, fool. We'll see about that. Okay, he died before he can even finish saying that. Okay, so no, we're not. Oh, we got level drained by the vampires. I did not even know. All right, whenever we get into the inn, we're gonna have to undrain him. It's just him. Okay. Bunch of gold and a Galvina's medallion. Who's Galvina? This is one of the medallions worn by the employees of Galvina's fest hall. It is used for identification. Really? It's considered a gem kind of thing. Alright. Boo says, Doran says, get out of my sight, or by all that's unholy, I swear I'll eat your rat for breakfast. Mean.
The city is no different from the forest. Men, dwarves, elves, orcs, we are all beasts. Some just have stronger leashes than others.
You make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
Bloodstone gem. And the dog. Dog has nothing to say. Dog is departing. Yeah, I looked in these. He's over here, right? Alright, so we can go help her. The way is clear. Is Kremi gone, sir? Can he hurt us no longer? He is dead. You and Aizen should go to see Callahan immediately. He will put you on the next ship to Olgoth's Beard. I do not know how to express my gratitude, Minsk. You have saved us in every sense of the word. Thank you so much. I shall go to tell Aizen. Farewell.
You feel lucky, Buck.
Don't say that to her. You're a lucky punk. As she walks past Dorne with the sword and... I told Ginny that I killed Kremi and paid Callahan to take her and her brother off the isle. She was ecstatic, of course. Can we follow her there? She's probably just gonna disappear. Yeah, she disappeared. Don't teach my hamster to suck eggs. Alright. 9,000 XP for that. Great. Let's go see what's in here. Oh, is this a temple? Priestess of Umberly, yeah.
Butt kicking!
Why
for goodness!
Do you disturb my meditations?
I do remember this. The Bitch Queen of the Deeps welcomes you to her house, mortals. Do you seek her favor in your travels? I do. What services have you available? I'll take that. Take these too. Gives you complete physical protection against the undead. Of course, spells, you know, won't help you against that. Alright. And this is, I think this, oddly murky. It appears, and it does not actually do anything. There's only four here. I'll grab those, because they heal poison as well as heal you. Control. Shift. Oh, we can't. I can't add anything. He's full. Never mind. Oh, this is Minsk, never mind. You keep that. You have that. Those are great. These are amazing. It's Flame Strike. Maybe it's less amazing than I thought, but when I was using him in the first Baldur's Gate, that was amazing, because I don't think I had Flame Strike back then. Alright, so I guess we'll... Oh, right, we were going to buy some regular potions of healing. Let's see how much we might need. He's got four. Nothing here. Really, I used the small ones. I could use a bunch, like at least 10. I use the small ones when possible, and I only use the big ones if it's a real dire need.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Okay, now we can do it. I was wondering why that wasn't doing that. I have four. Well, he has these, actually. He has these elixirs instead, so... Yeah, I'll just take the rest. Okay. See if there's anything else to see in here.
You know what? Long time ago? Yeah, I was like a moon blade.
Like a scaled down version of Venice or something. A moon blade, huh?
Swords! No! The bigger they are, the harder I hit! Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Wait, okay, is this place? Drunken sailor.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Excuse me there, Lerta. I'm feeling a wee bit woozy. Oh, he falls down. Captain, I'll put him in the hole till he's sober.
Sissy fighter, you grab, I'll scratch.
What? Captain Bob Holmes, there's Sanic. Pirate Noof. Pirate Scotty. Pirate. Innkeeper and courtesan. Pirate Jimmy, Pirate Paul, Pirate Dan, and Pirate Bill.